Welcome to the Spirit of Life channel. This message begin right now. The new energy of self-mastery. Beloved masters, what does spirit look like? Gaze into a mirror and see the reflection of spirit in your eyes. Gaze into the eyes of a child and see spirit looking back at you. Gaze at the sun, the moon, the stars, a mountain, lake, tree, flower, a bird, or an animal and know that the Creator is radiating the love/light of its spiritual essence to you through all of its creations. Please allow this thought to sink into your subconscious and conscious mind. You are in the midst of a transformational process, metamorphosis, of monumental proportions. Old truths are being replaced with higher truths as you become spiritual adults. The way you view yourselves, your world, solar system and universe is rapidly changing as your consciousness expands and you gain access to the intricacies of the cosmos. You are feeling the changes at every level of your beingness and, at times, it seems as though your bodies are rebelling as they go into overload, or take in more refined energy than can be easily accommodated. You must realize that more is not necessarily better, and you should always ask that you move through these times of great change with ease and grace. As old boundaries, superstitions, dogma, and limitations fall away, you are feeling vulnerable and it seems that there no longer are any set guidelines to follow. There is such a tremendous amount of new information available, some conflicting, and some validating what you may have accepted as your new truth. Please be aware that your truths will constantly expand and change as you move up the ladder of expanded awareness and enlightenment. Time as you know it has speeded up so fast you can hardly keep up. The hands on your clocks are moving so quickly, you are often shocked that the day is gone and it seems as though only a few hours have passed. The months and years are whizzing by also, and it seems as though you are on a crash course with your destiny. You are shifting in and out of the myriad energies of the multi-dimensions, which is one more reason why it is so critical that you stay grounded and focused in the moment, so that you don't lose yourselves or your way. By that we mean that you are responsible for the powerful, higher vibrational frequencies that you integrate, for with this new energy comes the ability to co-create more and more quickly anything you put your mind on and feed energy to. It is more important than ever to remember the saying, be careful what you ask for. Preoccupation with the past or future prevents you from experiencing the now moment, which is the moment of your God power. Learn to experience the freshness and joy of being fully in the moment. As with all new habits, it will take a little practice, however, it will soon become a natural state of awareness. Some of the challenges, shifts in consciousness and radical changes do not seem to make sense. Why would you manifest an illness while on your way to becoming a master? Why would you manifest a situation whereby you would have a bizarre accident, lose your job, your income, or a beloved partner? Remember, your higher self sees that you are confronted with the challenges and tests that you agreed to, at the appropriate time for your growth and better understanding. If you do not understand a situation, rise above it and endeavor to view it from a higher vantage point. Remember that it is not always about you, you only think so because you tend to take everything so personally. Also remember that you are in the process of transmuting all that is not based on integrity, self-empowerment, and a unity consciousness or the frequencies of unconditional love. Perfection is not a requirement. In fact, it is unattainable except within the heart of the Supreme Creator. All else is less than perfect in varying degrees. It is about becoming the real you and moving onto the middle path while existing in a world of duality and polarity. You have opened a Pandora's box that has been stored deep within your psyche for thousands and thousands of years. It contains all your core issues and beliefs about self-love, lack and limitations about your worthiness of love, joy, peace, abundance, and vibrant health, as well as your feelings about aging and the continuity of life. All these outmoded beliefs which do not serve your higher good are roiling up into your consciousness so they can be released and re-qualified into a higher frequency of light substance. You are becoming more intuitive and your telepathic skills are increasing by leaps and bounds. You are connecting with the many facets of your vaster oversoul and your God ray, I Am Presence, is now taking an active role in your transformational process as it filters to you the refined energies of new creation from the Creator Source. You are affecting everything around you during this process of refining your energy fields, for as you evolve inwardly and send forth higher frequencies of light, everything around you must also change. You have been told over and over again that you first must teach by example, and this is true. What better way to get people's attention than to become very successful at whatever you choose to do, to have vibrant glowing health no matter what your age, to display astounding and innovative creative abilities, and to be so loving and generous that others are awed by your compassion and your ability to see the best in everyone in every situation. The initiation process, or your transition into a spiritual/human being, is also accelerating exponentially as you analyze, resolve, release and realign with your new integrated frequencies of light, and all of this must take place while you are living within the framework or reality of the mass consciousness belief structure. The process of ascension or enlightenment in ancient times involved isolation away from other people and everything within the mundane world. It involved years upon years of intense study, discipline, and very difficult trials and tests before an initiate could move to the next level of the path. It involved tests so strenuous and dangerous that many times you perished or were maimed for life. You were placed in situations whereby you had to slow your breath and still your life force so that you could remain alive for several days without food, water, and very little air to breathe. Those tests were arranged so that all your weaknesses would come to the fore, and all your deepest fears would rise to the surface and would be exaggerated. If you had not learned to still your mind and your bodily functions and, most importantly, to stay in the still point of the moment, you would either go mad or perish from extreme fright. Those times are past. The ascension process is now geared to the masses and not just the select few. You must pass all the tests of initiation as you go about your everyday life, tests which are brought before you in everyday situations. Each test you pass or each lesson that you gain wisdom from removes a portion of the remaining imbalanced frequency patterns within, and after a time you become more proficient in getting the big picture and learning to move through the distorted patterns more quickly. As your proficiency increases, you are not moved so far off center and you do not dip into the deep levels of fear and despair of the past, but are able to maintain a more balanced level of awareness. You stop looking outside yourself for validation of self-worthiness. You know within your heart/soul that you are perfect and exactly where you should be at each and every moment in time. You also allow everyone else to seek their own path, in their own time and in their own way. The event called the Harmonic Concordance marked the time when the frequencies of Creator Light were greatly accelerated and, if you were ready and willing, you were catapulted into a greater level of higher vibrational patterns. Each level brings new gifts of awareness, but also more responsibility. You are learning to take personal responsibility for yourself and for all you create. Several years ago, we explained that as you move upward on the path of ascension, your spectrum of choice narrows as you move onto the narrow path. This means that you must always strive to make the highest choices, and many things that seemed appropriate in the past will no longer be tolerated. Your body will quickly let you know when it wants you to eliminate various foods or habits of lower frequencies, and as you become more attuned to the wisdom of your body elemental, it will apprise you of what you need to do for maximum strength and health, and also what you must eliminate in your life. This may vary from person to person, however, if you wish to gain or maintain maximum health and vitality and be able to integrate higher and higher levels of divine light, you had best take heed. New modalities for healing are emerging every day, and humanity is slowly becoming conscious of the fact that each person is responsible for his/her own health and well-being. The medical profession will slowly change into a prevention mode rather than a repair the damage mode. We will stress once more that light, sound, and color are the modalities of healing, balancing and harmonizing the human vehicle, and the use of these gifts will greatly accelerate the process of transformation. As you move deeper and more fully into your spiritual adulthood, can you not feel the connection between us intensifying as we shower down upon you all the radiance of our Father/Mother God's love from the highest realms of the universe? Yes, it is time for each of you to acknowledge and listen to the divine voice of the Creator within that is waiting to answer your every question and supply you with all the knowledge you need to move forward into the new age and evolution of humankind. It is time for you to determine which path to enlightenment you will follow, what rings true for you within your sacred heart. There is only one truth, and that is the eternal truth of the Creator, but it has been fragmented into many energies, thought forms and levels of truth. It is time to follow the nudgings of your higher self, as you claim the truth that resonates clearly within, and then follow it unerringly. Very soon, the time will come when channeling or telepathic skills will be commonplace around the world as more and more blessed souls clear the distortions which lead to a reconnection with their divine self and the wisdom therein. You are being given every opportunity to open or clear the pathway to your vaster self so that you may receive clear, concise information critical to your growth and transformation process. But you must begin by listening to the small nudgings you receive during the day or night, and after validating them in your heart/soul center, follow the guidance that feels appropriate, which should always be empowering, expanding, and loving. The light or divine cosmic life force from the heart center of the Supreme Creator is filtering into the places where the deepest, darkest shadows dwell, both in the world and within each of you. This creates a process of distortion, often confusion, fear, and discomfort. There is an ebb and flow of energies as the light gradually overcomes the shadows and they eventually melt away. Many of you are having experiences where you feel you are being bombarded by some external source. Know that it is your own inner demons you are facing, giving you an opportunity to, once and for all, release all the negative energy patterns that you have been carrying since the beginning of your first physical embodiment. It is of major importance that you discipline your mind and thoughts. What do you wish to carry forward with you into the new age of enlightenment? Your focus should be of both an internal nature and an external nature, for as you transform and raise the frequencies within, your outer world will radically change also. You have suffered enough poverty and deprivation, beloveds. Are you ready to reach out and claim the treasure chest with your name on it that has been held in trust for you? It has been waiting for you to awaken and to be bold enough to demand your birthright. You are the prodigal sons and daughters, under the protection of our Father/Mother God, who are returning to the realms of all possibilities. We fill you to overflowing with blessings beyond measure. I am Archangel Michael.